Hi, this is Tomas Lindberg from At the Gates. You're watching The Age of Metal.
This is Miguel with The Age Metal, and I'm here with Thomas Lindberg of At the Gates. How are you doing, sir?
Very good. Nice to be here. Thank you.
Well, it's been 7 years since the last time that At the Gates was in the United States. I mean, touring in a full force. I know you guys were here last year for the Maryland Death Fest, but coming with a new album in a full tour, what are your expectations now for this North American tour?
Well, I mean, we know it's been selling well, and you know Decibel is behind it, so we really, you know, we really just expect to have a lot of fun. Really, you know, there's a lot of good bands on the bill. The album is doing good, and you know, we just here to prove our relevance, you know, in 2015, and just enjoying it. Really, you know, we're really looking forward to this a lot.
All right, the album is being successful worldwide, including giving you a Swedish Grammy, what the equivalent for the Grammys in the United States. Yeah. Do you expect that kind of response to get to that point even?
No, of course not. I mean, we look at ourselves as an underground death metal band, and you know, anything above that is fantastic, really. We made this album for ourselves, to prove to ourselves that we could be relevant as a band. And anything, as I said, beyond that is just, you know, very, very, you know, flattering for us.
Well, definitely it was interesting when we hear that it's going to be a new At the Gates album after the success of Slayer of the Soul. And now, I mean, the first time personally when I listened to the album, The Altar of the Dios Desconocido, which is a part of a novel of Ernesto Sabato, and it's like a metaphor of God becoming the devil and God and good becoming evil. But in Spanish, what do you, I mean, at which point you wanted to do it in Spanish?
Yeah, because it's a lot of inspiration from South American writers on the record for the whole concept. Mm-hmm. And that passage, you know, in Spanish just sounded very natural because it's written in Spanish, you know. All translations, you know, just proved themselves more silly, you know. So therefore, you know, we thought it would be really cool to have something, you know, in the native language. And it sounds very powerful in that way, you know, in the Spanish language.
It is. I mean, as a Spanish-speaking person, when I listened to it, it was just definitely incredible. Yeah. I knew what it was, but then I was like, wow, this isn't an At the Gates album. This is amazing. Right. Now, it reflects the lyrical aspect of the album. It deals with magic realism, that we can see that on authors like Allende, like Sabato, like García Márquez.
Yeah.
How this kind of literary influences got into you in order to pour in into the album?
Well, I was reading a lot of these authors anyway, and then I started focusing on the ideology or philosophy behind, you know, the behind them, behind their books, and a lot of this, like, questioning the general Western worldview, kind of, and ideals. It kind of, like, became the big concept, and then each song has individual concepts, of course, but that, you know, the main, it was very easy to gather the songs around that main concept, you know, from that outlook, that perspective, you know.
I see. Now, going back a little bit, back to 2007, I was reading an interview, and you said that it wouldn't be a future At the Gates album, because it will be kind of like disrespect the aura around Slayer of the Souls. Yeah. But then, but you were opening to have another record under a different name.
Yeah.
What changed?
I guess we kind of grew into this, you know, real band again, you know, after being together for the reunion for such a long time. We just felt, everything just felt very natural, and it felt like a waste not doing a record. And in the end, it was really like, why release it under a different name if it's us, you know? So it's kind of like you make all these statements because you feel like that's how you feel. Or you change, and you know, everything changes all the time. That's the basic concept of the record as well, that everything is changing, so there you go.
Did the reunion shows between 2007 and 2013 influence the creation of the album at that point? At which point you guys decide, okay, let's make an album?
Yeah, I think, you know, the whole idea of playing all the old songs live and how they come to life in a live situation, you know, being played by us, the people we are today now, that's how the record sounds. It sounds like us playing At the Gates songs, and which it is, but you know, it kind of, it's like, it's not a follow-up to Sword of a Soul, it's a follow-up to the, our whole career, you know, keeping all the aspects of At the Gates intact. And I guess it just felt very natural for us, and we really wanted to prove the point that we were, as I said, relevant, that we had something to say still, you know.
Well, I guess the worldwide response it gave you that you guys is still relevant and really important for the death metal scene. Now, the question is, will this be the last At the Gates album?
You never know. You know, our statements is not my, you know, uh-huh. I'm not very good with statements. I always break them.
Okay.
But there's no plans for it being the last album. Mm-hmm. But you never know. And we just want to enjoy this now, where we are right now.
One thing that I think is humble from At the Gates, always referred itself as a death metal band and as an underground metal band. Nowadays, with everybody putting input on that kind of label, what it takes to be an underground metal band?
I guess it's the way you look at the music scene and the you know, music in general and life in general, that, you know, you try to like stay away from the mainstream and all the, you know, the rules of the music business in a way, and you know, you just try to be your own entity and stay, you know, within the scene. For us, it's very natural, so it's even hard to describe it, but not saying yes to stuff, you know, corporate shit, just for the sake of it, you know, basically.
Gotcha. Now, At the Gates is definitely the original founders, part of the original founders of the melodic death metal scene that grew up in the 90s. Everybody knows that. But at that time, it took a long time for you guys to, you know, create that scene and bring back death metal at that time that it was pretty much ruled by grunge and a different kind of sounds. In your opinion, which other bands you see that now are taking that responsibility of keep death metal alive?
Well, there's a lot of good bands out there. I mean, there was a trend for a while to just, you know, doing the underground stuff and doing the retro thing, you know, just repeating what people had done before. And that kind of became a big thing. But then I reckon there's a lot of bands right now, you know, doing... It's retro in one aspect, but they're still moving forward. That's the way I want to see it. Like, you know, trying to create something new but keeping this that underground death metal aura alive still within this new thing, you know.
Okay, kind of like keeping it real.
Yeah, but still developing at the same time. Yeah, that's what we want to do with this new record too. Like, you know, not becoming stale and just cynical, but moving forward, but keeping it real. Yeah.
Well, now talking about Slayer of the Soul is definitely considered one of those key albums on death metal. And I was talking with Michael Stein about The Gallery, which the albums came out at the same time, 20 years ago this year.
Yeah.
In your opinion, do you think that Slayer of the Soul will have the same appealing and the same response if you were released today?
You never know, man. You never know about stuff like that. Hopefully, you know, But we didn't get that response then, really. That response came afterwards. So it'd be hard to say, you know. And now everybody knows that kind of style, and then that kind of took them by surprise then. It's very hard to say, actually. Yeah, hopefully.
Now, I hear that Sandam, the creator of Merrill Headbanger's Journey and Merrill Evolution, is creating documentary about Slaughter of the Soul. What we can see in that documentary when it came out?
Well, we will actually see that the first cut of that when we come to Toronto on this tour. They're going to show it to us. And they got a small theater for us and, you know, going to show it. So we don't really know exactly everything yet. But they were there at a local show in Gothenburg for us and filmed the whole show and made a lot of interviews and around the Gothenburg kind of footage. So I'm looking forward to see it because they're very talented people, of course. So
it would be something from a local vision more than a global approach?
Well, I don't really know. But I mean, the show is shot in Gothenburg, so yeah, we probably have some local connection, yeah.
Now, talking about South America, I saw a small date back in September in Bogota, Colombia, which is going to be the first time that you guys are going to be ever there. I'm quite excited for my native countrymen.
Yeah.
What are your expectations from South America? What are your expectations from Bogota? Have you ever been in Bogota before?
No, I mean, we went to South America once a couple of years back, and that was fantastic. It was crazy.
Chile?
Yeah, Chile, Argentina, Uruguay, Brazil, Costa Rica. Yeah, I think that was it. We landed, you know, we had a layover in Bogota, and that's it.
Okay.
Yeah, that's it. No, I mean, Colombia has always been a strong metal scene, so we're looking forward to that, of course.
Now, closing up, Thomas, what is next for At the Gates after the Decibel Tour?
We're having a lot of shows up until the summer. We're no long tours. We're doing a couple of Swedish weekends. We're doing Poland. We're doing South Africa. And I think we have something in France as well. But this is like a few weekends up. And then it's the whole European festival summer, which is going to be crazy. An Australian tour, the South American tour. So, yeah, there's plenty of stuff. Yeah. Good stuff, though.
All right, Thomas. Definitely looking forward tonight from some of At War With Reality material and some old school material. So definitely looking forward to it. Thank you very much.
Thank you, man. Good times.